Hello, sports fans. Welcome to Super Sports Central. Today, we're going to be going over my Week 5 UFL Power Rankings. So, briefly recapping Week 4, the Battlehawks beat the Showboats by a score of 32-17. The Stallions defeated the Defenders 20-18. The Brahmas beat the Panthers 19-9. And finally, the Roughnecks beat the Renegades 17-9. But this week's rankings at number 8 or last, we have the Renegades. They are now the league's only winless team after they fell to the Roughnecks by a score of 17-9, and they were terrible in the loss. Their offense, which had been pretty good so far through 3 weeks, they were not good this week, scoring just 9 points. And quarterback Luis Perez, who had been a very bright spot for what has overall been a bad Renegades team, he also struggled this week, finishing with just 144 yards, a touchdown, and a pick. And the Renegades offense wasn't any better on the ground, as they rushed for 40 yards on 18 carries, which is just 2.2 yards a carry. Defensively for the Renegades, it wasn't as bad as it had been in previous weeks, but that could also just be because they weren't playing a very good offense. But the Renegades fall to 0-4 on the season. There's not many bright spots for this team, and they're likely already out of the playoff picture after just 4 games, and the Renegades are at number 8. Number 7, we have the Houston Roughnecks. They picked up their first win of the season after they beat the Renegades 17-9. It wasn't a great performance, but they did what they needed to do. Quarterback Reed Sinnott built off a good performance last week and finished that with an even better performance this week, as he ended the game with 191 yards and a touchdown. Then on the ground, running back Mark Thompson made his season debut, as he had 9 carries for 34 yards and a touchdown, and provided a spark to the Roughnecks run game that finished with a season-high 76 rushing yards. And then on the defensive side of the ball, the Roughnecks played extremely well and their best game of the season by far. They held Arlington to just 9 points and forced 2 turnovers. But the Roughnecks, they got their first win of the season, and we'll have to see if they can build on that as the rest of the season progresses, because if they can improve, they're still very much in the playoff picture. They're only 1 game back with the second spot in the USFL Conference, and after the win, the Roughnecks, they enter at number 7. Number 6, we have the Memphis Showboats. They're at number 6 after their third consecutive loss, falling 32-17 to the Battlehawks. The Showboats played a solid first half, being down by just 3 points at halftime, but then in the second half, they completely fell apart. They did not score a single point in the second half, and had just 22 yards of offense the entire second half. Now, looking at the entire game, the offense wasn't great, just 127 total yards, 3.3 yards of play. Although they were able to put up 17 points, the offense was still not very good. The Showboats' offensive line did not play well again, allowing 4 sacks. And then defensively for Memphis, they didn't really do anything well, allowing 32 points, 355 total yards. Couldn't stop the run or the pass. Just a bad overall week for the Showboats. They've now lost 3 games in a row following their Week 1 win, and the Showboats are at number 6, desperately needing to turn things around. Coming in at number 5, we have the DC Defenders. They lost to the Stallions by a score of 20-18, which drops them to 2-2 on the season. But the Defenders definitely played a solid game. They gave the Stallions the best game that the Stallions have played so far, the most competitive game the Stallions have played. And the Defenders overall played pretty well. Offensively, quarterback Jordan Tayama was good again, 161 yards and 2 touchdowns, also 24 rushing yards. And wide receiver Kelvin Harmon had a great game with 5 catches for 93 yards and a score. And this receiving core for DC, which had struggled to start the season, they're really starting to settle in and become a solid group of pass catchers for Tayama. Then defensively, for the Defenders, they played pretty well, holding a good Stallions offense to 20 points. And forcing 4 field goal attempts. But in the end, it wasn't enough for the Defenders. The Stallions came out on top. But the Defenders, after a slow start to the season, they looked to be finding their groove. And they played very well against definitely the best team in the league. They have a huge game next week when they face the Battlehawks. But the Defenders are at number 5. I can understand the argument for having them a little higher. Coming in at number 4, we have the Michigan Panthers. They remain at 4 despite their 19-9 loss to the Brahmas. The Panthers' offense struggled and was a big reason for the loss. The offense put up just 9 points, and the offense has been very inconsistent so far this season and needs to be more reliable for the Panthers to be a truly good team. Panthers quarterback E.J. Perry left the game with a hamstring injury and did not return. So that is something to monitor heading into their Week 5 matchup. Backup quarterback Danny Etling played pretty well in place of Curry, throwing for 105 yards, a touchdown, and a pick. Now, a big reason the Panthers' offense has struggled so far this year has been poor offensive line play, and that was a problem again this week as the Panthers' offensive line allowed 6 sacks. Then defensively for the Panthers, they were pretty good again, despite allowing 305 yards of offense. They only allowed 19 points, and they put the team in a place to win, but the offense struggled, and the Panthers fall to 2-2 after 4 weeks, and they're at number 4 in my power rankings. Number 3, we have the Brahmas. They've remained at 3 after they improved to 3-1 on the year with a 19-9 win over the Panthers. The Brahmas' offense was without starting quarterback Chase Garbers, but it was not a problem as backup quarterback Quinton Dormady made his UFL debut and played a really good game, passing for 269 yards, a touchdown, and an interception, and showed that the Brahmas' offense can still be very good without their starting quarterback. Now, the Brahmas struggled to run the ball, averaging just 1.9 yards a carry, but the pass game led the way, and the big reason why was they had 2 100-yard receivers. Justin Smith finished with 5 catches for 107 yards, and Jonte Kirkland finished with 5 catches for 105 yards. Then moving to the defensive side of the ball, the Brahmas, they played really well, allowing just 9 points, forcing 3 turnovers, and generating 4 sacks. Oh, sorry, 6 sacks. But overall, a great win for the Brahmas over another good team, and they're at number 3. Number 2, we have the Battlehawks. They remained at number 2 following their 32-17 win over the Showboats. Their offense was amazing with 32 points, and they did a lot of things well on the offensive side of the ball. Quarterback AJ McCarron was very good, throwing for 222 yards, 3 touchdowns, and a pick. Receiver Jakor Pearson made his season debut and made his impact felt instantly with 10 catches for 80 yards and a touchdown. Plus, the Battlehawks ran the ball extremely effectively with 133 yards on 6.3 yards of carry, including 103 yards from running back Jacob Sowers. On the defensive side of things, the Battlehawks were great as well, allowing 17 points, just 127 total yards, racking up 4 sacks, and the Battlehawks are definitely the second-best team in the UFL. They enter at number 2. And at number 1, it is the Stallions. They remain at number 1 after they beat the Defenders by a score of 20-18. Now, it was their closest game of the season, but they were still able to come out on top and are now 4-0. Quarterback Matt Corral played well, passing for 240 yards and a touchdown while also adding 51 yards on the ground. And it seems like the Stallions are going to continue to alternate quarterbacks after both quarterbacks Matt Corral and Adrian Martinez played very well when they each got to play a full game. So we'll have to see who ends up being the starter next week. But against the Defenders, the Stallions also ran the ball very well, rushing for 130 yards. And Stallions kicker Ramiz Ahmed was great, who was signed on Tuesday after their usual kicker Chris Blewett was injured. But Ahmed, the new addition to the team, went 4-for-4 on field goals, including a game-winning field goal in the final seconds. And the Stallions remain at number 1 as the league's only undefeated team. But those are my Week 5 UFL power rankings. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, subscribe, comment, turn notifications. I do my best to post as often as possible. Let me know in the comments if you agree with my rankings, disagree, and why. I'd love to hear your thoughts. But thank you for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, comment, turn notifications. I do my best to post as often as possible, and I will see you in the next video.